outer lives, you may have seen a lot of billboards, advertisements, movie posters, and the likes. But who made them? That is what we're going to talk about in today's video. So, in today's video, we are going to talk about graphic designers. So, we are going to talk about those people who made those advertisements, those movie posters, those anime posters, cartoon posters that you see all around the internet, printed in the movie theaters, and etc. So, what are graphic designers? So, by definition, graphic designers create visual communication for entertainment, advertisement, news, and features in all forms, including print, publications like magazines, newspaper, brochures, and digital media such as game machines, television, web browsers, social platforms, and portable devices. Basically, those are what graphic designers do. They do visual communication. They communicate with the audience using newspapers, posters, okay, and a lot more. So what are the duties of a graphic designer? What do graphic designers do when they are working? Okay, first one, they create visuals that will deliver the desired message. Each graphic design that we see has a message. Let's say, for example, they want to promote the newest Star Wars movie. So, of course, they are going to make a movie poster related to Star Wars. Another example is that they want to promote this new product, okay? So, they are going to make a poster or an advertisement related to that product. Graphic designers are also responsible for layouting and selecting the colors, images, and typefaces that are going to be used in the poster or in the graphic design that they are going to do. So if their clients have, let's say, another idea for the design or another suggestion for the design, they are also responsible for implementing those changes that their clients want. Or let's say they have learned a new technique, a more efficient and a more beautiful way to make the layout. They are the ones responsible in incorporating those changes in the design. They also meet with their clients or meet with some people to know the scope of the project or the scope of the design, as well as present the concepts to the clients when they are readily available. Of course, review the layouts that they have done before they even publish it, okay? They do proofreading, spelling, grammar, if the color is consistent with all the fonts and all the text, and all the layouts and the design and etc. Okay? They are the ones responsible in checking for those. They also use a graphic software like, for example, Photoshop or Adobe Illustrator to create those graphic designs. So graphic designers have different specialities. May they be book design, branding and advertising, print and web production, typography, and of course, web design. Okay, so a lot of people can be graphic designers, okay? Because there are a lot of choices. There are a lot of fields that they can go to. Let's say you only know how to create a web page design, okay? Then you can be a web designer. You only know how to make a typography, then you can be a typography artist, and a lot more. So, what does it take for you to become a graphic designer? Of course, first, you must have what we call an eye for aesthetic. So, being aesthetic knows what colors to use, how the perfect pieces fit together in a layout, okay? So it is having an eye for beauty. You know what looks good, you know what looks bad, you know what fits in this particular design, you know how to incorporate the theme of the design. That is being aesthetic, basically having an eye for beauty. Next one, a graphic designer must be imaginative, okay? Every graphic design begins with a concept. Basically, that concept came, of course, from your imagination. So without a broad imagination, without using your imagination, you will not be able to come up with concepts. So basically, a graphic designer must be imaginative. You must be able to come up with different designs, different layouts, different concepts for each project that you do. Graphic designers must be also open-minded. You must be open to criticism. You must be open to changes. You must be open to learning. You must be teachable because you cannot know everything. There is always someone out there that is better than you, that creates more, better, efficient, maybe time efficient, cost efficient way of doing something. So you must be teachable. You must be open to changes, open to criticisms and likes. And of course, you must have the strong desire to be able to cope with the different design trends. You must be able to cope with the changes in the industry, the changes in the trends, the changes in how the world sees design, and etc. It is not wrong that you have your own artistic style, but of course, you must be open. You have the strong desire to fit in, or you must have the strong desire to be better at what you do. That is what makes a great graphic designer. Okay, now we go to the required skills a graphic designer must have. Of course, when you are working for someone as a graphic designer, or if you are a graphic designer yourself, let's say a freelancer or a student knowing how to do graphic designing, okay? So you must have certain skills that you need to acquire, or if you have them already, you need to develop them in order to become an effective graphic designer. Okay, the first one is communication skills. Everything is better with proper communication. Everything can be resolved with constant and proper communication, even in graphic designing. Of course, if you are working with a team, you must communicate with your teammates, okay? If you are a freelancer, a solo freelancer, you must communicate with your clients in order for the desired outcome to be the product of what you do. Constant communication. You must have great communication skills. Okay, next is creativity. Not everyone is creative, okay? That's a fact, that is reality. Not everyone is creative. But it is not wrong that you get inspiration from other artworks. Again, take inspiration from other artworks. Do not copy artworks. Taking inspiration from artworks sometimes stimulates your creativity because it challenges you how you can improve on that design or stem out of that design and create your own style of design. Let's say, for example, you want to take Disney's art style as an inspiration. Now, incorporate that into your design, okay, and then add a little more, add a touch of your creativity, of your imagination, okay? That is how people with not enough creativity get by. And in that way, if you learn how to do that, then you may become a great designer yourself. Next, you also must know how to do sketches, because after formulating a concept, you must sketch it down. You must sketch the design in order for you to have a basis, okay? For you not to forget what you have thought of, for you not to forget about the concept, you must sketch the design on a piece of paper. And that way, when you are going to make the design, you have a basis of what you are doing. You're not just throwing punches to the moon without any basis, just doing work. You need to have a basis, and that is why graphic designers must know how to do sketching. And you also need to be techie or tech savvy, okay? So being techie refers to being, let's say, handy with the different tools, softwares like Photoshop, Illustrator, and etc. that are being used in graphic designing, okay? If you want to start a graphic designing career, you must know how to use those softwares even in the very basic level. You must have a basis for further learning, okay? Before learning more advanced techniques in graphic design, you must first know how to use the different tools, of course, for you to be able to be more effective, okay? For you to be able to learn quicker. in graphic designing. Lastly, graphic designers must have a great sense of time management. Okay, you must know how to efficiently do your work with the time given, because all graphic design projects have their deadlines. Okay, so with the given deadline, you must know how to create the desired product that you are tasked to do. Sometimes graphic designer must do a lot of project all at the same time. So that also incorporates what we call the time management skills. You need to know how to finish all those jobs in the given time period that you have. Okay, so that is it. So remember, if you want to become a great graphic designer, you must apply the different skills that have been discussed today. Okay. So if you want to have a reference for this lesson, you may head down to the description box down below. I will be putting a link wherein you can download the free module that has the lesson that is in this video. So that is it for this video, and soon enough I will also be posting lessons related to animation and programming, as well as the lesson 2 for our empowerment technologies. So better stay tuned, better subscribe down below. Click the bell notification icon so that you are updated when our next video comes out. Do not forget also to like, comment, and share this video. So that is it. See you next time, and goodbye.